प्रेज द लॉर्ड एवरीवन। टुडे वी स्टार्ट विद जेनेसिस 28। इट इज नॉन अदर देन द हाउस ऑफ गॉड, द वेरी गेट वे टू हेवन। द नेक्स्ट मॉर्निंग जैकब गॉट अप वेरी अर्ली। ही टुक द स्टोन ही हैड रेस्टेड हिज हेड अगेंस्ट एंड ही सेट इट अपराइट एज ए मेमोरियल पिलो। देन ही poured olive oil over it. He named that place Bethel, which means house of God, although it was previously called Luz. Then Jacob made this vow: if God will indeed be with me and protect me on this journey, and if he will provide me food and clothing, and if I return safely to my father home, then the Lord will certainly be my God. And this memorial pillar I have set up will become a palace for worshipping God, and I will present to God a tenth of everything he gives me. Genesis 28:29. Jacob arrives at Padan Aram. Then Jacob hurried on, finally arriving in the land of the east. He saw a well in the distance. The three flocks of sheep and goats lay in open field beside it, waiting to be watered. But a heavy stone covered the mouth of the well. It was the custom there to wait for all the flocks to arrive before removing the stone and watering the animals. Afterward, the stone would be placed back over the mouth of the well. Jacob went over the sheep herds and asked, "Where are you from, my friends?" "We are from Haran," they answered. "Do you know a man there named Laban and grandson of Nahor?" he asked. "Yes, we do," they replied. "Is he doing well?" Jacob asked. "Yes, he is well," they answered. "Look here, comes his daughter Rachel with the flock now." Jacob said, "Look, it is still broad daylight, too early to round up the animals. Why don't you water the sheep and goats so they can get back out of pasture? We can't water the animals until all the flocks have arrived," they replied. Then the sheep herds moved the stone from the mouth of the well, and he watered all the sheep and goats. Jacob was still talking with them when Rachel arrived with her father's flock, for she was a shepherd. And because Rachel was his cousin, the daughter of Laban, his mother's brother, and because the sheep and the goats belonged to his uncle Laban, Jacob went over to the well and moved the stone from its mouth and watered his uncle's flock. Then Jacob kissed Rachel and he wept aloud. He explained to Rachel that he was her cousin, on her father's side, the son of her aunt Rebekah. So Rachel quickly ran and told her father Laban. As soon as Laban heard that his nephew Jacob had arrived, he ran out to meet him. He embraced and kissed him and brought him home. When Jacob had told him this story, Laban exclaimed, "You really are my own flesh and blood." Jacob marries Leah and Rachel. After Jacob had stayed with Laban for about a month, Laban said to them, "You should not work for me without pay, just because we are relatives. Tell me how much your wages should be." Now Laban had two daughters. The older daughter was named Leah and the younger one was Rachel. There was no sparkle in Leah's eyes, but Rachel had a beautiful figure and a lovely face. Since Jacob was in love with Rachel, he told her father, "I will work for you for 7 years if you will give me Rachel, your younger daughter, as my wife." Amen. God bless you all.